Alrighty, time for round two of, I said Bonesaw's Revenge last time, so I guess, I don't know what the follow-up is, but...
After waiting what felt like 8 years for the rest of the rounds to finish.
Yes, that is actually true. Alright, well, we waited and got a great hand as a result. We've got a... I'm moving the cards around so you can't tell, but I've got a... I've got a turn two Immobilizer Eldrazi into turn three Nettle Drone.
That seems pretty sweet.
Yeah, with a colorless land. And yep. Then if we draw a black source, we have Havoc Sower.
For the untapped value. There we go. Like you called it.
Boom.
Is this normally how you keep your the hand size to...
Oh, yeah. I guess I could go a little bigger. There we go. Yeah. Or were you saying the other way around?
I was going to say the other way. I tend to err on keeping the hand smaller since everyone saw us draft. So maybe not that small, okay. But like so they know what's in our hand.
No, this is exactly what Grim asked for. We're gonna keep
precisely exactly what I wanted you to do. Thank you.
I mean, it works. Just watch on a big screen.
Thank you for respecting my wishes to the letter.
Yep.
See, I didn't say anything because I knew that was gonna happen. So,
is there a way you can make the cards bigger? There probably is. I don't know how to do it though.
Make the
cards bigger on the field without making the hand
the
tiny?
Gear, I think they're probably at the max because they're just doing... Yeah, they're auto-sized. I mean, they're as big as they can be.
Yeah. Oh, I see.
I think you just want to leave it on auto.
Yeah.
See? You learn something new every day. I probably shouldn't double block a first striker here.
No, that seems bad. All right. There we go.
All right, happy medium?
Happy medium.
So now that we've given everyone a headache.
Yeah.
Would you say we're sowing havoc?
Uh-huh.
No. The answer is no. You would not say that.
No.
But, yeah, probably just playing our, like, colorless things.
Yeah.
And boom. Setting up next turn maybe to either attack with Havoc Sower and have its +2/+1 ability up, or use a Mobilizer, which can make the Cultivator stop blocking. Also, our opponent played a Dada's Commando into a Eldrazi, which is like, I guess kind of what we're doing, but still not really a combo.
Yeah. What's the Cultivator Drone do? Taps for a
Wingding, and then you can spend it to play colorless spells, activate abilities of colorless permanent, or pay a cost that contains a colorless, including, you could actually activate this because it's a colorless permanent. We wanted to wheel that spawning, but oh yeah, we have two Flare Drones. No, we had not drawn those yet.
Oh yeah.
Any 3-cost card would be kind of nice to get this Bushwhacker out, but I guess it depends on what our opponent plays. We might not even want to do that. Because I guess if the Zada's Commando hangs back, then these can't attack even when Bushwhacked. I should make sure I'm not F6'd. What do you got? Thought Not Seer.
Oh, that's a good card. I mean, they get a Bushwhacker out of this?
Yeah, I guess that's not a disaster, but...
Yeah, the 4-4, though.
It's still a 4-4, yeah.
Havoc Sword can start
doing
what its name implies. Yeah, it can attack as a 5-4. I guess our opponent can either block with Thought Not Seer or double block with the Cultivator and the Commando, and either way, that's, like, pretty good. Not land? No. Mm.
Turns out it was land.
Yeah. And a shocking twist. I assume we're the beatdown. I mean, it's too late now, but... So if our opponent takes it, I guess we just smack them for 5.
Yeah.
All right. And then hopefully draw, like... Actually, drawing a Swarm Surge wouldn't be terrible either.
Oh, wow, yeah.
I wouldn't mind trading for Thought Knots here. That would be good.
I think they're considering it.
Yeah. I mean, they really could double block with Commando and Cultivator and trade those two instead. I don't know if that's much better, though. They could also just take it and attack us back with Commando and Thought Knot and even Cultivator if they wanted. They have a lot of options. I think they're probably just going to take it. Yeah. Boom. We can activate Blighted Fen, but I kind of like it as a colorless source. I guess with a Nettle Drone out, we really are just the aggressor, right? It's like at any point, this can just start doing 2 a turn, assuming we draw spells.
You can activate it next turn, though, right?
I could activate Blighted Fen next turn. I can activate Nettle Drone also.
Yeah, but not you couldn't have done it this turn.
No. I couldn't have fended this turn. So we're gonna hit for 6 here. We can take it. Problem is our opponent has 5 cards in hand.
Yeah. It's one of the problems.
Yes, one of the many problems.
I mean, we're about to tie the game up at end of turn, so, you know.
Yeah. If we draw, like, Kalidus, that would be sweet.
Yeah.
Or what other big cards do we have? Do we have anything else?
It's about as big as they get.
Yeah. That's good. Embodiment of Fury is very good. All right. Looks like Havoc Sword might have to stay back, especially since our opponent didn't play a land, so they have four spells in hand. Okay. Also, our Mobilizer Eldrazi's are not really working because our opponent does not have a...
Yeah. They're not playing the cards we wanted them to play.
Yeah.
The Embodiment makes 3/3 lands on landfall?
It makes 3/3 lands. It does trample. They have trample. But Havoc Sower as a blocker is pretty good.
Yeah. Just eats a 3/3.
And keeps the Thought Knot Server back, keeps the Commando back. They could attack with Embodiment if they don't care about trading it for Havoc Sower. Could also block Embodiment with Nettle Drone. They don't really like doing that.
I like Nettle Drone a lot. Maybe too much and to my detriment.
Yeah, Nettle Drone's great. Did you see the picture someone posted of Nettle Drone and Expedite next to each other?
Yes.
That was amazing.
Nettle Drone's really excited to get somewhere.
Yep. Blink. Okay.
They've missed their land drop twice in a row now, so.
Yeah.
All right, well, at this rate, Nettle Drone's just going to win us the game, so that's great.
I'm down with it.
Looks like Shrieker's not bad either. I guess we'll keep land in hand so we can pretend like we have something. So that Gravity Negator is kind of going to get us.
What's that one do again?
So it's 2/3 flyer, and when it attacks, you can pay a Wingding and give a creature flying.
Right.
So they can hit us for 6 in the air, so we're actually dead next turn?
They do have Wingdings available. Oh, yeah, right. Yeah, I guess we are dead next turn. Look at that.
Yeah, that's not great.
That's neat.
So what are we hoping to do?
Oh, they saw the line.
Yeah, lucky.
Oath kills the... Yeah, 2/3. I think that's the only card, though, that we have that's our out here.
Our rare sorcery speed lightning strike.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, can't think of killing the 2/3 would make it so our opponent couldn't kill us anymore. If we draw Swarm Surge, does that do anything?
That's a problem as well, because now they have two allies.
So oh, yeah.
Yeah,
can start draining. Pinging us. Okay, well, that's that, I think.
Your opponent won't block. The desperation attack, as usual. I guess I could have made Kozak Shrieker Menace, but I don't think that helps either.
You can still pump it, though.
Yeah, they don't have it. They block there, they block there. Yeah, whatever. They figured it out. Tears of Valakut kills the flyer, but... I hate setting that card in, but I've only seen one card it goes against.
Yeah.
This kills both Zadis Commandos. That actually could be great.
Yeah.
This doesn't kill the flyer.
Doesn't kill the flyer, no.
Could take out Blightherder, I guess. Can't take out Bonesaw. We've already kind of gone over this.
Yeah. I mean, obviously the Bonesaws are integral to the...
I mean, we didn't draw them. We didn't win.
Right.
Hence.
We won all the games where we drew Bonesaw, and we've lost all the games where we haven't drawn Bonesaw, so...
That's enough of that's enough of a sample size for me.
At some point, we need to decide in the exploit to combo with the Nettle Drone, just to assemble Tron.
Yeah. Nettle Tron.
Yeah. Yeah, somehow it just looked absolutely ridiculous.
It just looked like he was frolicking through a field. Just like,
wee.
His arms out behind him.
Just looks like he's in a hurry to get somewhere.
Yeah.
We also have the dubious distinction of finishing our game first, which is the problem we ran into last round.
Yeah. That's why we were waiting for 40 minutes?
Yeah.
No, maybe not quite that long.
All right, time to redeem ourselves. Let's go ahead and play first. No, that's not going to do it. Wow, we have 3/2 drops.
Okay,
four 2 drops, but no. Can't just keep a 1 liner on the play.
Oh, hello.
Yeah, here we go. I mean, it's not optimal.
It's not fast, but we have some good friends in the hand.
Yep. All right, let's keep... Ooh.
Actually.
That's quite good.
Yeah. So if we go Foreigner Slaughter turn 2, Nettle Drone turn 3, Kalidus turn 4, or something. Yeah, this is the card that I have not ever seen really go off. Like, it's, yeah, presumably good in this, like, red-black aggro deck, but I've never seen it really just go nuts. That wasn't a Netherger at all.
The Forerunner?
Yeah. I mean, I know the card is good. It is good, but... See, it would have been perfect to, like, give something haste, but... No.
I had a couple turns in the pre-release where I was able to turn two, like, Sky Scourer or the Salvage Drone? The 2-2.
Oh, look at that.
That you can give Death Touch. And then turn three, Forerunner giving itself haste and bash for a bunch.
Yeah, that's great. The Toyota 4Runner.
Toyota 4Runner.
Huh. Didn't expect that I wanted to trade there,
yeah,
but that's
people
fine.
Are really keen to trade off for it.
Yeah, trading when we have Cletus in hand isn't great, but I thought our opponent wouldn't trade, and honestly going 4-drop, 5-drop, and then Cletus, or 4-drop Cletus is still pretty good. Also, our opponent didn't play a land last turn.
Yeah, because you can do Cletus next turn off Unknown Shores, right?
Yep.
Yeah.
This is the one where you tap a generic and tap it to add a mana of any color. Opponent getting some work out of Hedron Crawler.
Yeah.
Offline, though.
So what cost three that we saw last game? I don't even know. Maybe nothing. Oh, just... Yeah,
okay.
That's not great. Right, well, I guess we don't have to play... Oh, let's play this first in case our opponent chump block. Not that that's really going to happen. So next turn we can play Translator and still activate the Havoc Sower. I think we're going to go to game three in a second here.
Yeah.
Just because Cletus is like basically unbeatable and our opponent's stuck on lands. Like, even if it's just a 4-mana 3-4 lifelink, this card's very good.
Yeah.
Opponent doesn't have a fourth land. I guess they can... they might be able to like surge a Boulder Salvo. But it's playing like...
You're really good at calling shots, so you should... Oh, yeah. You shouldn't say things like that.
All right. Oh. Embodiment of Fury. So that means Cletus has to stay back.
But the sower can get in.
Oh, yeah. Translator first, so if we have to use it, we can activate Havoc Sower. I guess just send.
I mean, you're probably activating it.
Yeah, I guess... Almost no matter what, but I guess in this case, not. But
yeah.
Right, we get a zombie out of the deal, so that's pretty good.
Yep. And the thing that was preventing...
This card is so good.
Cletus from attacking.
Right. Ooh. Once you have Kozlex Translator in play, you have to like keep using it on your turn so you could then use it on their turn. Get an extra mana out of the deal.
With the Essence Depleter, that can be relevant.
Yeah. Essence Depleter is really good.
Yeah.
Don't have one here, but that card is fantastic. Looming Spires.
That's fine.
Alright, I was worried about not attacking with Cletus because maybe he had a trick, but Looming Spires makes it a 4-5 first trick, which makes it fairly unlikely our opponent can do anything here.
Also the zombie ability, or the zombie sack.
Yeah.
So it can become a 6-7?
6-7 first trick. So put maybe trade with a zombie, but then we just don't get a zombie. So it's like, at that point it's just like chump blocking.
If they just don't block, is it worth it to... pop the zombie anyway because you deal the same damage but gain life but you lose the zombie?
If I didn't have Silent Skimmer in hand, probably, but I'd rather just play the Silent Skimmer. I guess we don't have a chance.
Don't yeah. Get to find out.
Fair enough.
Yeah. So what did we learn?
Hold
on, I want to make that picture. I can't do it. There we go. This is what I do.
Do it all over here. The card's bigger.
What's up? Oh yeah, that's a good point.
Oh, so that card's out
of scale now. Yeah. That's almost funnier.
I led you astray.
Yeah.
Tiny legs.
All right. What were we doing?
Oh, yeah. That concludes our sideboarding discussion.
Good sideboarding, everyone.
Yeah.
Honestly, that's about average sideboarding in general. We're on game three while multiple other matches are on game one, at least, so there is that. All right. Point capped. I guess we're keeping right. Yeah, two drop, three drop. Spark Mage's Gambit. Also, we saw a Hedron crawler, so Spark Mage's Gambit has some value.
That seems fine.
Commandos all day long.
Did we Tron our two Zadas commandos to so we can activate him?
Okay.
I see your Zadas commando.
Yeah, raise you one.
Well, it's not. You're just seeing the Zadas commando.
No, so far we're just seeing it.
We will raise them one, but yeah. I assume we're going to shriek first.
Yeah, so we can go turn three shrieker, turn four.
If it's another okay, it's not.
Yeah.
Oh, that would have been sweet.
It's funny that they don't attack, but we wouldn't have blocked, so. Alright. Shrieker, and then turn four we can go commando plus gambit.
And activate the first commando.
Yeah. Hopefully they play another one toughness creature here. They're probably just going to play a Thought Knot here. I'm just going to lose to it. But, but.
To be fair, Thought Knot Seer is not what? No.
Well, this is not the next one.
That's a Thought Knot Seer.
Yeah.
I guess they just take the translator?
Probably. What I was saying is Thought Knot Seer is not actually what killed us. It was the Gravity Negator.
That's true. The Gravity Negator is what ultimately did. Well, it's what enabled the Thought Knot Seer to kill us, but yes, it was the Gravity Negator.
Yeah, I guess
that
it was
the cause of our demise.
Yeah.
Though, you know, if they don't take the translator, then we can still block it. I guess we can also. Yeah, we can, like, double block Thought Knot Seer with Zadas Commandos. Like, this isn't the end of the world.
No.
All right, they took the translator. They should hit with the Zadas Commando, probably.
Unless they're planning on...
Nope.
No. We can't activate the Shrieker, so...
I don't love any of these options. They're all, like, kind of medium. Could kill the Zadas Commando, get in for five, play another Zadas Commando. Is that good? It's not terrible. The downside of that is that if they play another one toughness creature, we like lost a Spark Mage's Gambit, but the upside is that we get a lot of damage in.
Yep.
Sure.
Zzt. Yeah, and Spark Mage's Gambit, of course, has the can't block clause, so.
So do they just crunch back for six, or...?
I think I'm okay with that. Depends what they play. If they, like, hit us for six, then play a decent blocker, I'm less happy. What is this? Oh, a Cloud Manta. Well, that's not even a good... That's not a good blocker.
Not against our board.
I guess they can hit for six, and then the Cloud Manta can trade for Shrieker, but if we draw a colorless land, which we didn't.
No.
All right, time to start skimming off the top here. And we've got Zadas Commando to plink our opponent. This isn't too bad.
Mm-hmm.
Like, Skimmer could block Cloud Manta if we wanted to. Wouldn't mind drawing a removal spell, or... Even a colorless land wouldn't be too bad. If we could activate the Shrieker and attack, that would be really good.
I like having four power first strike blockers that still have use.
Yeah, that is pretty convenient. Yeah, whatever. No fear.
That's free attack for them, basically.
Yeah, it's not like it's keeping them like, all right, brute strength, sure.
Yeah. How much should we take off that?
We take two. An extra two,
two?
Yeah. I don't think we have four allies, though, so we can't activate it twice. That was a bad draw.
Yeah.
Like, imagine if we just drew a colorless land, could activate a Shrieker, and then could attack and put enough to block with Thought Knots here, which would then kill with the Shrieker and then draw a card. Oh, that sounds great.
That sounds like a world I want to live in. Let's hope that happens.
As long as we have a lot of good draws. We can draw a good spell, or we can draw a colorless land. The only bad draws are just, like, the normal lands, which we've got a lot of, but if we draw any of the colorless lands, that would be great.
Still, though, doesn't that Altart Mountain, like, freshen up the...
yep, exactly. All right, not land. Ooh,
oh, there you
there
go.
There we go. Actually, technically, I should have attacked first in case they have the tap a creature it doesn't untap.
Or if they forgot.
Yeah. Now what? This is a good card. I've been impressed by this card.
Yeah, I like the Shrieker. I had one in the pre-release, and it unfortunately didn't show up as much as I would have liked. But well, we're getting to do that thing that you wanted to do. All
right.
Draw a card.
The thing yeah. I was. That's it.
The thing I was.
Perfect.
Yeah, we, yes. There we go.
Perfect.
That was the sound of millions of people's head hitting the desk.
We could play, but we might need to enable Surge in the next turn.
Absolutely. On our one Surge card.
Yeah.
Which is also an ally.
Ooh, yeah, that's true.
Which is not helpful. It doesn't let us activate any more Zada's Command.
But it does mean if we lose one Zada's Command, we can still activate.
True.
If our opponent doesn't have much, the second Shrieker is going to really get in there.
Mm-hmm.
Also, another reason to keep Bonesaw back is maybe our opponent doesn't know it's coming, so they might set up a block which an extra point of power just throws into disarray. That's maybe ambitious, but... alright. Bonesaw is indeed ready. Let's equip the Zada's Commando. Let's go to attacks. Better get him for three than one here. Attack. Menace. And menace.
So much menace.
Yeah. If our opponent's taking it, that's a ton of damage.
Yeah. Okay.
Alright.
Oh, okay.
And Bonesaw plays both sides of the court equally well.
That's true. It blocks the cultivator.
Yep. Our opponent looks like they're flooding out a bit.
Although they hit 7, and a lot of gross stuff happens on 7.
True. Also, we have 7 lands in play in one of our hands, so I guess that's also true of us.
Yeah.
I just don't know what their 3 cards are. Like, what? They're just not playing anything.
Maybe they're more land.
Yeah, that could be. They missed a land drop?
Yeah, they can't be more land.
I mean, maybe they're just holding it to bluff or something, but they could be like a counterspell of some kind, maybe like a situational one, or...
Fall of the Titans? They wouldn't use that.
Yeah, why would you?
No.
Oh, a Dwar Isle Avenger. Okay.
More Flyer Surge.
And they're surging a Bushwhacker.
Ooh.
Are we dead?
No.
We go to 2 if they attack with everything. Hey, 2 is not 0.
I mean, they can attack with everything, though, right?
Yeah, if they attack with everything, they die.
Yeah.
I like that. So, yeah, this makes sense. They were holding a Bushwhacker. They're trying to set up, like, a good Surge turn. Maybe they were holding both these cards, and they were, like, really trying to get us. But right now, so what happens? So they have to keep 2 blockers back for the Shrieker. And we do actually get to Blighted Fen them, so they have to keep... Well, they don't have to keep 3 back. They can sack a tap creature. All right. Yeah, just takes 8. We draw a good spell. Ooh, is that
Wait,
good?
Does that work?
It makes this unable to block.
Huh.
Actually, that might be enough, right? We can play this. Makes this unable to block. That they have to double block the Shrieker or die. And then these 2 commandos get in for lethal. And or they block each on a commando, but the Shrieker's lethal.
Yeah.
Well, yes.
Cool then. Go Eldrazi.
We will immobilize our opponents. I assume this all works.
Let's find out together.
We're about to find out.
I guess we're like pretty dead if it doesn't, but I think this does work. Yeah, they can't block.
Yeah, they have. Yeah, this works.
Menace. This is not, you know, this is not a draft of us doing the math. This is a draft of us attacking with everything. But yeah, this does look like it worked. Was Bonesaw good? I don't know. But
I mean, Bonesaw doesn't need to be here for us to win, but it's important that it was.
Yeah, apparently. I like when our opponent sends a message and it's polite and saying good games, otherwise. So, kudos to our opponent for being kind. And there we go. Boom. 2-0.